Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in this topic basically we are going to talk about the important compounds of the carbon, that is carbon monoxide, and in the next lecture we are going to talk about the important compounds of carbon, that is carbon dioxide. So let me talk about this one, that is what are the different preparations or method of preparations of that is carbon monoxide, as well as what are the different chemical properties of carbon monoxide. So this is all we are going to cover in this topic, so let me discuss about that. So talking about the important compound of carbon, that is carbon monoxide. So in this topic we are going to cover the preparations as well as the properties. So let me talk about the preparations of the carbon monoxide. So as we have got to know earlier also, that is during the discussion of the physical as well as chemical properties of carbon. So in that case basically we have also discussed about a certain reaction where carbon monoxide and carbon dioxide, the both are being produced when the carbon undergoes the oxidation reaction with that of the O2 molecule. So similarly we are going to talk about that is what happens if the carbon, it undergoes a reaction with that of oxygen so as to produce that is carbon dioxide. But in this case basically carbon dioxide has been a stable molecule, so therefore it has been formed. But what if we supply a limited quantity of the oxygen? So in this case basically we could get that is 2 moles of carbon monoxide. So this is how we will get if we supply limited supply, or if we supply limited quantity of O2. So this is how we will get. So this is the reaction where oxygen is being reacted with that of coke, and basically we could get carbon monoxide. And now let us talk about the second preparation, that is from organic acids. So for that we know, that is if we talk about the organic acids like that of the formic acid, like HCOOH we represent in this manner. And suppose if this undergoes that is dehydration process in presence of that is H2SO4, and if we have heated it, so obviously the water molecule that would be liberated, and that is how H2 would be released, along with that of there will be formation of that is carbon monoxide. So this is how we'll get. But it can also be obtained from oxalic acid, and oxalic acid is nothing but we could represent it with H2C2O4. And suppose again it undergoes that is a dehydration process, that is what we have mentioned over here. So in this case basically we have to use sulfuric acid, along with that of we have to supply a certain amount of heat so that we could obtain that is carbon monoxide, along with that of that is carbon dioxide and H2O. So since H2O both are being released, so therefore it is also called to be a dehydration process where basically water has been released in this case. So now so this is what I was mentioning about how basically the carbon monoxide has been obtained. And now there are also few reactions that I want to talk about where we could obtain carbon monoxide. So let me discuss about that also. So the next one is, basically we know that carbon doesn't react with water molecule. But if you talk about the coke, so coke that could be very much reactive. So in this case basically what we are trying to show is, basically if a carbon is being reacted with that of especially coke, if I'm talking about, so if it reacts with that of the H2, then the product that we could get basically on heating, we could get carbon monoxide along with that of that is H2. So this mixture of carbon monoxide and H2 gas is basically known as water gas. So this is how basically carbon monoxide, as well as we could say the synthesis of water gas, has been happened. And but the coke can also be react with the air, and that air consists of oxygen as well as the nitrogen molecules. So in this case basically, suppose what I'm trying to make sure that if I supply that is oxygen along with that of the nitrogen which has been present in the air, so in this case basically the reaction would occur in such a manner that with suppose if a certain amount of heat energy if I supply it, so therefore the product that we could obtain is basically 2CO plus 4 moles of N2. So basically this is known as producer gas. With a certain amount of heat, that is 1273 Kelvin, so that much amount of heat should be supplied, and that is what we could get. So now let me talk about the uses of these two gases, or water gas and producer gas. Since we are talking about carbon monoxide that has been obtained, so this carbon monoxide can undergo through combustion reaction That is, yes, it can react with that of the oxygen so as to form that is carbon dioxide, along with that the evolution of heat. So thereby, these two gases are basically used as a fuel in various combustion reactions and various industries. So therefore, this were certain kind of the preparations of carbon monoxide that I have discussed over here. So this were about the preparation, and now let us move on to the properties of carbon monoxide. So this is the properties of or basically we could say that the chemical properties of the carbon monoxide. So as I've said earlier also, that is, carbon monoxide is playing a very important role in the metallurgical process. The reason behind that is because carbon monoxide is acting like a very good reducing agent, and that's the reason that from oxide, that is when we are talking about the metal oxide, so it has a capacity to take the oxygen which is associated with the metal stored itself, thereby basically enhancing the metal oxide to have a that is lower oxidation state, and then how we could say that a pure metal can also be formed. But this is what I was talking about, metallurgical process. So let me give a few ideas that how basically it acts like a reducing agent. So for that we have to mention certain reactions, like suppose while extracting iron, that is from its ore, that is, suppose if we have that is Fe2O3, and if we react it with that of the carbon monoxide, and that is basically CO. So on heating, and basically this is obtained in a blast furnace, that we could obtain the molten iron. In that case, basically the carbon monoxide has been acting like a reducing agent, as well as it would help in that is removing the impurities also. So in this case, basically the product that we could get is basically we could get 2 moles of Fe along with that of that is 3 moles of carbon dioxide. So this is how it has been used in metallurgical process. And talking about the next one, that is it has also not only for metal oxide it could be act like a very good reducing agent, but for other metals like that of, suppose if I'm talking about copper, so suppose copper oxide, if it undergoes that is oxidation if it undergoes reduction in presence of that is carbon monoxide, so on heating basically we could get copper along with that of CO2. So this is somewhere I have mentioned about the uses of the carbon monoxide also. So now let us talk about the next one, that is how what it plays a role in biology. As you know that oxygen has a tendency to form that is bond with that of the hemoglobin which is present in our blood. So if we inhale carbon monoxide, or if suppose if carbon monoxide has been formed in our body, so what will happen? It will create a poison. Yes, since we know that the carbon monoxide is basically, it is very much it forms a very stable complex, or it forms a very stable structure if it combines with that of the hemoglobin. So that hemoglobin will basically retard the supply of oxygen throughout our whole body, and that's how basically it can act like a poison. So let me give an introduction for this thing. That is, suppose if we talk about the hemoglobin, suppose like Hb, which is I am representing it as hemoglobin, if it combines with O2, then basically we'll get an oxide like HbO2. So that is very much important for our body, so as to basically to carry the oxygen through various parts of our body and through blood. And what happens if the same hemoglobin is been treated, or it has been reacted with that of the carbon monoxide? So in this case, basically the compound that we could obtain is basically COHb. So this is known as a compound which is very much poisonous to our body, and that is basically known as carboxy hemoglobin, and so that is how it is not necessary for our system. So now let me talk about the further uses as well as further properties of the carbon monoxide, and that is basically it has a tendency to form complex. So whenever it has been reacted with the other metals, like suppose if I'm talking about nickel, so whenever nickel is been combined with that of the carbon monoxide, so it forms that is a complex, that is NiCO4. So this is how basically we could prepare complexes like that is tetracarbonyl nickel, and various other complex can also be prepared with the help of that is carbon monoxide. So there are also certain properties, that is if we talk about the structure of carbon monoxide, so let me discuss about that also. That is, the structure of carbon monoxide in terms of the Lewis structure, it has been found to be that is in this manner, where we could see that there is a lone pair of electron on the carbon, making this to be a negative charge, while the positive charge will be on the oxygen. Since oxygen has a two lone pair of electrons, but that has been associated with this carbon atom so as to form a triple bond, and that is how basically it will have a negative charge on it, and that is how we could say that oxygen has positive charge on it. Basically, this acts like a Lewis base, and that is what I want to talk about, and even this is a property that we could talk about, and that's it. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood the various methods to prepare carbon monoxide as well as various properties of the carbon monoxide. So I hope I'll see you next time. So till then, don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel, and thank you so much.